Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today we're not sewing.
Aww.
I know. We're going to work on this wall because I want to paint it. I thought, why not asking some more questions? I answered the 20 questions from 2021 in January. Anyway, for this year, Costube has a new list of questions. We got 21 questions to answer, so I thought, as I'm working on taking off all the stuff from my wall, I will answer some questions, or at least I try to. And yeah, let's get started. What is your favorite genre of costuming? We start with the ironing board. I like to do historical costumes, and I like to do costumes from screen, especially Star Wars. I did a lot of Star Wars costumes in the past. And yeah, let's get started on the room. The real question is where to put all this stuff. I think I would put it all on my big table and then I can move my table out of the way and access this wall. Space. Move on with another question. What originally got you into costuming, cosplay, living history, etc.? It was 1000% Lord of the Rings. I just wanted to have a costume like in the Lord of the Rings movies with the big sleeve and stuff. And yeah, that's what got me on my mother's sewing machine, and I started and I never really stopped. Who do you look up to? Who taught you your crafts? And I have to give props to the community. For me it was always learning by doing, learning with help from the internet, from tutorials. I come from a smaller city. I'm now living in a big city, but I come from a small city. At the time when I wanted to learn sewing, it wasn't cool. It wasn't a cool thing at that time. And there was no class or something like that in my hometown, so books, internet, the community, that's what I'm still do today actually. And with my channel I hope to be a part of that as well. Which of your projects are you the proudest of? I recently finished the Hamilton Spencer, which is from the Hamilton musical, designed by the Hamilton costume designer for the musical, and it's basically a Regency Spencer, and it was quite a project. I spent a lot of time on it. I did many things that I haven't done before, and it came out quite okay. I have a video about it. Question number 5. Are you team cut or team trace in regard of pattern paper pieces? I'm team trace because here in Germany the patterns that I use are often quite expensive. Nowadays I really love to work with PDF patterns because I can print them whenever I want, and so there's not so much tracing anymore, but if I had to choose, I'm trace. The next question is pins or pattern weights, and I mostly use pins, although I'm looking for nice pattern weights for a while now. I don't have any so far, so right now I'm team pins. Next question, what skill would you like to learn? I'm actually actively working on the skill that I'm dreaming of. It's digitizing embroidery, which I already did. But there's still a lot to learn and I'm working on that right now. And beside of that, a more practical skill would be draping. But I still don't have a dress form that has my measurements, so I probably have to make them. I already said that in the 2020 question video. Oh well. Sewing machine number 1. Maybe it would be a good idea to get some boxes. Got my boxes. from the basement. How many pieces are lurking in your UFO bin? Well, actually, I'm quite good at it when it comes to costuming. I have 2 unfinished costumes. One is actually finished, but actually not. I'm sure you know what I mean. It's actually just a belt. And another one is for my husband, which actually only needs some gloves and some stuff in the basement, some painting stuff. But I'm actually quite good at not starting a lot of things at the same time. When it comes to everyday clothes, I'm not so good because that's so damn boring. I think I have 10 pieces or something that needs repair, and I do it. I really do. I really do believe in repairing stuff. Absolutely do. But fancy new costumes are fancy new costumes. What is your favorite tool to use? And I have to say it's my industrial machine. I got her last year and I love it. She's so fast and she sews like just so smooth. I love it. And besides that, I think it's my patchwork quilting ruler, because I use it all the time. I bought it 10 years ago and there's no project where I don't use this. It's awesome. I love it. Next question. How has the pandemic changed what and how you sew a craft? I think it's opened up a lot more time, and after some very strange weeks at the beginning, I actually used that time, I guess. Oh, I started my YouTube. I actually started it already in 2019, and then I got discouraged because I didn't like my first video at all. Yeah, I'm actually quite happy that I restarted my YouTube, because now I really enjoy it and I have this new room, and yeah, here we are. I need something for this, all the hooks and stuff. What did you do or learn in the past year that you are most proud of? I said it already, but I think YouTube. I'm far away of being a pro, but I learned a lot of things, and I learned more things about lighting and cameras and stuff. It's pretty cool. And I'm still learning a new thing with every video. Next question. What costume would you like to revisit? I have plans on revisit a Star Wars costume of mine. I actually sold parts of it just recently, and it's my Resistance Rey costume. It's the one from episode 8, and she wears a very cool gray vest and braces, and I think it's my favorite costume of her, and made it from wool in the past, and it was lovely. I was quite proud of that costume, but I always wanted it from linen, and I found pretty linen a long while ago, and I really have to make the new version. In my head I was like, oh, just paint one wall, it's easy, it's fast. Most useless sewing tool you ever invested in? I actually have it somewhere here. I bought this ruler, which I thought would be a good idea for pattern drafting, but it actually doesn't stay exactly how I want it to be, so I don't think I ever used it. Yeah, so winner of this question, my bendable ruler. Do you pick a project and then procure materials, or collect materials and let them speak to you? I was the latter in the past, but I'm getting better at just buying stuff for projects that I'm actually planning. I say I'm getting better. Nobody's perfect. I cannot pile up fabrics and materials. I mean, I could, but I don't have the space for it. Yes. Oh. One of my little helpers. Meow. Okay, so now I got my... What is it called? What are your goals, plans moving forward? I want to continue with my YouTube. I also plan on opening an Etsy store, or maybe I should say reopening, because I already had an Etsy store in the past, and I will offer some costume accessories and embroidery patches. All the stuff that will come to my mind. Next questions. Do you have any sewing assistants, aka pets? Number one. Say hello. Say hello in cat language, please. We have 2 cats, 2 bunnies, and 7 chickens. They actually don't help me with sewing because they're actually not in my sewing room. That would be very weird. But they soothing my soul and therefore they're helping me as well. So now let's do the books. Yes, it's another sewing machine. Why do you ask? Look at him, isn't he cute? Got him last year when Halloween season hit and I love him. We actually have some more questions. Do you sew over your pins or take them out as you go? I absolutely take them out. Machine sewing, barefoot, socks or shoes on the pedal? I'm team socks on the pedal. I actually cannot sew with shoes on, but I think it's because I'm just sewing at home. So I usually just wear socks and yeah. Okay, here we are at the book nook. 2 more questions, then I can actually start painting this wall. Tea, coffee or chocolate? I drink my coffee in the morning and I really love my coffee in the morning. I would prefer tea in the afternoon and chocolate on the evening. And question number 21. What do you like to watch or listen while sewing? And I think it will not be a surprise if I say Costube. That's actually the reason why I'm making videos. And sometimes I listen to movie soundtracks. Okay, so that's it for the 2021 edition of the questions. Please check out the full playlist of the 21 questions. Also, please check out Cozy, which is an event coming this August from Costube for you. I will put all the info about that in the description box below. Hello from the editing. I missed a question, so to make this video actually 21 questions, I have to answer another one. So here we are. The question I missed out was biggest sewing or crafting pet peeve. And I have to say that is fitting because that's very hard and it's very time consuming. And for me, the fun stuff begins after the fitting.